In this video, I will show you how you can paginate a collection in the frontend using a load more button. Here I have a collection of data that is not especially voluminous, but contains 995 items. So it's not so heavy that I need to add back in pagination, but it has too many items to display them all on a user's browser without slowing down the page. First, let me open the inspector and fetch this collection. So you see here that it's quite small. It's only 70 kilobytes. So even though there are 995 items, it's not a big set of data. So it doesn't require pagination in the back end. However, if I try to bind my entire collection, all the items on in WeWeb, you will see I get a warning. First, it's quite slow because the browser needs to build all 995 items. And then in WeWeb, in the editor, we only display 200 items. This is so that the editor doesn't crash. But if you publish your app without resolving this warning, then the 995 items will be displayed in your user's browser, and it's likely that their browser will either crash or at the very least slow down very significantly. So in order to solve this problem, you need to add front-end pagination. You could use the paginator element in WeWeb. We have a dedicated video on the topic, or you could use a load more button. This is what we're going to show you now. So the first thing we'll do is on our items, instead of showing all 995 items, we are going to use the slice formula. So we can look for it here, right here in array. And we can type it in here as well. So slice parenthesis, and I will close my parenthesis and hover over slice to understand how it works. And it was a little bit slow because, again, for now, it's still loading all these items in the browser, so it's slowing down the editor. So here, the slice formula, if you're used to Airtable or Excel or Google Sheets, you will be familiar with formulas of this kind. Here, the first argument is saying, what array are you going to? This is our set of data. Then what is the start index? In programming, the first item is always 0. And then where do you want to stop? I want to stop here. I want to load 20 objects, so from 0 to 19. And on my page, instead of having all those items, I only have 20 items. Let me change it to 10 so it's even more obvious. There we go. What I want to do now is make this dynamic. Instead of hard coding the 0 and the 10, I want to refer to a variable that I will create now. So in here, I will create a load more variable that will be of type object. And it will have two pieces of information, the start index, which is set to 0, and then the end index, which we just set to 10. But this will be the default value. Let me create this variable. And now what I can do is here, instead of 0, I can bind to my variable load more and bind to the start index. And I will do the same with the end index. There we go. Sorry, it's a bit slow again, because since I am changing this formula, it's loading all the items. So now, there we go. Again, I have these 10 items from 0 to 9. All right. So now I can use this variable to, if I change this variable, this will be dynamic. So let me add a button below our table here. And here I will say load more. I will remove this icon here and here. So it will be on the primary button. I don't want any left icon or right icon. And on click, I will create a workflow. So I'm on this button. I will create a new workflow to update load more variable. And here I will choose an action that is to change the variable value. Look for it here to save a little bit of time. And here, depending on my use case, I could choose to update the start and the end index. In my case, I only want to update the end. So the path here, I've enabled partial update, and the path here refers to end, which is what we have here. So it refers to this. And the value will be the current value of end plus 10, because I want to load an additional 10 items. So now my collection, my list of items, instead of stopping before the 10th index, it will stop before the 20th index. So let's test it here in preview mode. Now, if I click on load more, you can watch here what happens. Load more. Now it says 0 to 20. So here, this is referencing my load more variable, so my 20 here. And I can keep going. Load more. And let's click. Now it's 30, and so on and so forth. So if we wanted to, instead of updating the end index only, we could update the object entirely. So let's go back to the default. Let's save 10. And here, instead of a load more, we could have a next. So let's say container. Let's put that here. And now instead of a load more button, I will have previous 10 and next 10. So and next 10. You can change this, of course, but the idea is now that instead of updating only the end, we will update everything, and we will say, we will create an object. And here, the first thing we say is we'll say that the start key has a value of the current start plus 10, and then the end key has a value of the current end plus 10. Let's see here, start will now be 10 and 20. So this is to get, this would be, no, so that would be the opposite, it would be minus 10, and here, minus 10. And in order to prevent going from the to index minus 10, which we don't have, I will have a pass-through condition that says that you only want to do this if the allow this if the start is more than 9. So if the index is 10, you allow the previous 10, otherwise you won't pass through. So here my workflow is at, should actually be called previous 10. There we go. And here previous. And here I will copy this workflow and paste it here and say next 10. And here I do not need my pass-through condition. And here instead of minus 10, it will be plus 10 plus 10. So now I can disable, can remove this one. And let's see what happens. Let's go here to load more. So I'm starting on start. First of all, I just want to make sure this doesn't work. So, okay, that's great. It doesn't work, which is great. To improve the user experience, I'm not even going to give them the option. They won't even see this. This button will not even be rendered if the start index is minus, is below 10. So let's add a condition where if load more start is under 9, I don't want to display it. So there we go. So now it's not even displayed. And if I click on next 10, this is updated. The items here are updated. And because my condition here is met, I can now see this button because the start index is higher than 9 since it's 10. That's it. That's how you can paginate a collection in the front end using a load more button, or if you want to go one step further, a little navigation with previous and next buttons.